Bonjour!
Bonjour!
No.
Time for bladder check.
Check.
So, it's a show?
It's a lifestyle. It's a religion.
My emotions! My emotions!
I'm still French.
Ouais, c'est pas faux.
I'm a woman, Mary. I can be as contrary as I choose.
Non, moi je crois qu'il faut que vous arrêtiez d'essayer de dire des trucs.
Hello, hi, I'm Laura. I'm gonna watch The Haunting of Hill House Season 1, Episode 6. I watched the first half of the season weeks ago now. Maybe you know it, maybe you don't know it, but I'm making reaction videos and I made reaction videos for other shows, you know, for the new season of The Expanse, for the return of Vikings, for the end of Mr. Robot, for the end of the season 1 of It's Dark Materials, you know, I had a lot of other shows to react to, so that's why I made a break, you know, for my binge watching of this show, of The Haunting of Hill House, because this show is out since a long time now, so I wanted to be right on time for the others, which were just out, you know, and to take my time to binge watch this one. Again, it's out since a long time now, so that's okay for me to wait some days, some weeks to watch the rest of the season and to post reaction videos about it. Today, normally, I have the time to watch 2 or 3 episodes. It will depend on the weather, on the lights. We will see that during this binge watching. So yes, I binge watched the first half of the season a long time ago now, but I posted my reaction videos about it. I think it was last week and the week before that. And you know, the more I think about it, about the first half of the season, and the more I'm like, okay, that was great because they presented us this family, they presented us all of the members of this family, all of the brothers and the sisters. That was great, you know, to follow them, to understand each one of them, to understand their background, to understand what happened to them into the past, but also now. We don't have all of the information about all of them. We have, you know, just some clues about what happened and what's happening now. I'm still not sure that I understand everything that happened and that is happening. Like, for what happened into the past, we understood that the mother died, we understood that the father left the house with the kids because he wanted to protect them from the mother. I'm still wondering about that. I'm still suspicious, you know, about him, about his real intentions, because he left the kid, you know, into the motel and then he went back to the house and he came back with blood on his hand. And you know, Sio, when she touched her mom when she was young, she saw that her mom was hurted on... Yes, she saw stuff about her mom being hurt. And we saw also some things, I think that it was on the episode with Nell or something like that, about her father being violent or having, you know, excessive moments, you know, and I don't know. I'm still suspicious about him. I'm still wondering about him. We'll see if I'm right or wrong about that. But the last episode was really great, the one with Nell, because I wanted an episode about her and I was a little sad, you know, when she died in the first episode. I was like, no, we're not gonna have it because she's dead, and no, finally we've got it. And that was great because I wanted to know more about Nell, because I wanted to meet her, really. And also because of the episode on itself, maybe it was the more horrific episode for the first half of the season, for what I watched, you know, about the show for now. Yes, I loved it because it was really interesting to see her meeting an husband, and we knew that she had an husband, and I said since the beginning, since we knew that she had an husband, that it was weird that we were not talking about him anymore, like he was not around anymore, and I thought that he was dead, and I was right about that. He's dead, and that was interesting, you know, to understand that before our episode and to wait for that moment into our episode. So we've got that moment, we've got moment with Nell being paralyzed, you know, into her sleep. That was really stressing, and of course we had that final scene with her going into the house, hallucinating stuff into the house. She saw her brothers and sisters when they were young, but also her brothers and sisters when they were adults. She saw her mom. She saw that thing, you know, that the mom wrote into the wall, but that's fucking weird because we saw that when they were young, you know. The mom was saying, you did that, Nell, that's something really bad, you can't do that. And Theo said, no, she didn't do it. Theo touched that thing. So I'm really intrigued about Theo, about what she already knew, about what is happening and what is gonna happen, you know. Did she know all of that since the beginning? I mean, since the moment that they entered into that house, touching things, did she know already all of that? The fact that it was the mom who wrote that thing, but in the future for them, like, we have to have a time traveler thing, you know, into that house. Because also when Nell hallucinated, we've got the mom who's dead, we've got her husband who's dead, we've got all of the brothers and sisters, young and adult, but we've got also the Hills family and we've got also the Dudleys, you know. And I'm also wondering about them. Can it be possible that I have two theories about them? Maybe they're dead, you know. Maybe they're dead since the beginning and we are seeing them since the beginning. Like, they are made, you know, into the house, they are coming with the house and all of that, but maybe it's because they are dead and they are haunting this house and they are the only one that the new owners of the house are seeing and are considering, like, they are alive, but in fact they are dead. That's one of my theories. I know it's really creepy and it's really weird, but that's one of my theories. And the other one is the fact that maybe the Dudleys are alive but know about everything that is happening into the house and they are the keepers of the house, something like that. I don't know, we'll see. But there is something with this house. For me, it's really like the house is calling back home, you know, everyone who lived into the house once. And if you lived into the house, if you were owners of the house, you have to die into the house to live forever into that house. For me, it's something like that. That's my theory for now for this house. We'll see if I'm right or wrong about that. About the brothers and the sisters, I have to say it, maybe I'm more attached, you know, with Luke and with Nell. I was attached to Theo and I was really feeling connection with her because of the empathy thing, you know. I'm really in empathy with people. I think that you can see that into my reaction videos. You can see that I'm really in empathy with the characters of a show and I'm like that in real life. I'm in empathy with people in real life when something is happening to them, when they are feeling something, I'm feeling the same. So that's why I was feeling connected with Theo, but like I said, the more I think about the first half of the season and the more I think that Theo, she had to know. She had to know stuff that happened, which will happen. For me, she knew stuff. She had to know stuff, you know, because of her power, because of her sensitive power, because of the fact that she touched that wall, she touched her father, she touched her mother. For me, she knew things. We'll see if I'm right or wrong about that, but that's why I'm not loving her anymore, you know. I'm not as connected with her that I was before because I'm a little suspicious, you know, about her, about what she really knows. Shirley and Steve, I'm not disliking them, I'm not hating them for sure, and I'm not disliking them, but I'm not really interested by their stories, by their backgrounds, by their points of view. Also, I'm not I don't have the impression that they were really involved into what happened and what is happening, so that's why maybe I'm not really interested by what they can do and what they can say, for now at least. We'll see if it's gonna continue like that or not. About this second half of the season, I'm expecting it to be like the first half of the season, like one episode for one character, for one brother or sister, and that can be interesting. And I'm also waiting for the final episode to be about the dad. I'm not sure that I'm gonna be right about that now, but I'm really expecting that. Like, for me, the dad is the key to everything, to understand everything. We'll see about that. So I'm gonna stop talking right now and let's go for this episode 6 of the season 1. Of the only season, if I understood correctly, how this show is gonna work. Like, one season for one house, you know, for one storyline about one horrific stuff. And this one is about the Hill House. So let's go for the episode 6 of this season. Oh, and also I prefer to warn you, my neck really hurts a lot. I don't know what I have right there, but it really hurts, so I'm sorry if sometimes during the editing, you know, I have to keep one moment where I'm, you know, I don't know how to say it in English, où je me masse à moi-même, où je fais quelque chose comme ça, it's because my neck is really hurting. Oh, look. Yeah, the special connection with her. Oh. Look. Hmm? We're not together anymore. Be cool with her. You're being a dick, like usually. He was a dick with Luke also, you know, during that dinner. Look, there is no music. It's really giving to this intro, this scene, a realistic environment. We just have the storm, you know. That's her detective. Positive. I'm sorry. What did you just say? I miss you? You're seeing her being there? That was Nelly? Really? I'm not sure. She went back to the house. She didn't tell anybody. She hung herself in the neck. Was broken. The bump neck lady. Mrs. Dudley talked to her? The fact that they are all having a weird relationship with their father, you know, they are not close to him, it really makes me wonder about him even more. You're my first suspect. You're my first and only suspect. They are still young for you.
Thanks for being here.
That was an interesting shot. He's still considering them as children, you know. Oh, I'm sorry. I just saw that I had French subtitles and not English subtitles. It's the same for me, but I'm putting English subtitles for you. He's talking to the mom. That's who he was talking to, you know, into the motel room. No! That's so creepy and sad.
Thank you for taking care of.
Really, no music at all since the beginning, just the storm. It's really giving more a realistic atmosphere to all of that. A lot of scenes which are made with only one shot, you know, no breaks, no cuts into it. It's just the camera going and going without any breaks. For the way of doing this episode, it's not like the other ones. It's really changing the rhythm of the episode. This way of filming, it's really... Sorry, I was not ready. It happened before. Yes. Another?
I know. Seriously? Exploded. You're okay. I'm gonna go check it out.
Watch your step. It's glass and floors like someone threw it. That's not weird at all. This house can't survive to a storm. Go ahead. Go with your sisters. You're staying here with Nell. I said during one other episode that she just had Nell and Luke, you know, into her necklace. Why? Why just the two of them? The way of filming this episode really intrigues me. You hated it? I thought that she was loving it. She was saying that it was her dream house. Nelly? Really? Are we sure of that? You could feel her hand. You were giving the hand to the wrong Nelly. It's really like no breaks. You didn't succeed.
Luke. Still. Luke.
Oh, it's made up at first.
Padded, puffy envelope.
No.
She got that from your mother, you know.
Alcoholism.
Again, no breaks for that scene.
Oh, well, at least to write letters to Santa. Hey, I don't know if you're not so much. You know, he might get confused. Dear Mr. Claus is Mel Crane Boston. The thing is, guys, you know, she would never ask for anything for herself, ever. Not once. She only asked for presents for you guys. Had to make sure we got you what you wanted, what she mentioned in those letters.
That's sweet. She was sweet as a child. As an adult. She was the one who was.
There's seven of us, and now there's five, because two of us decided to die. She knew the price the rest of us pay when someone does that, and she did it anyway.
She was forced to by her mother, she was hallucinating. Invisible. I think that the house is working like that. I don't see a break since the beginning of this scene.
So maybe she mentioned something in one of her monthly letters.
That's so interesting because it forced us to be, you know, to be focused on the show, to not let them down, not even a second. A lot more, in my opinion.